Tony Ray here. Ken Buesseler has been monitoring radiation levels in water collected near the Fukushima Dai-ichi nuclear plant, which was damaged in the Japanese earthquake and tsunami in 2011. Who I to test for radioactive Pacific Ocean water by Cynthia McCormick. See McCormick at capecodonline.com. Woods Hole. The Woods Hole Oceanographic Institution has launched a new citizen website to pay the cost of testing Pacific Ocean water for levels of radioactivity. The idea is to help the public keep a close eye on a plume of water containing radionuclides or radioactive elements from the Fukushima Dai-ichi power plant in Japan, who I senior scientist Ken Buesseler said during a teleconference on Tuesday. The new website, ourradioactiveocean.org, allows members of the public and coastal communities to support testing the water samples at Huai. The power plant was badly damaged in the March 2011 earthquake and tsunami and has been leaking radioactive water into the ocean ever since. Water containing radioactive cesium-134 should be hitting the U.S. West Coast, including Alaska, any day now, but it's hard to know for sure since no U.S. government agency is responsible for monitoring radioactivity in the ocean, Buesseler said. No U.S. government agency is responsible for monitoring radioactivity in the ocean. Well, that doesn't really make any sense to me because radioactivity would be a threat to the American people and everything living in the ocean impacting the coast, but the U.S. government isn't responsible for that. Okay. He believes the radiation will be too diluted after traveling 5,000 miles across the Pacific to have an impact on American fishing and recreational activities. But Buesseler said the American public has the right to know what the radiation levels actually are. It's something I think should be monitored for the U.S. public, Buesseler said. What I expect are low numbers. If we don't have data, it's very easy to speculate and alarm people. Buesseler says the website is an example of crowdsourcing. Individuals and communities put up $100 in seed money to propose a testing site. If Huai selects the site, the scientific organization will set up a fundraising webpage to help the group pay for testing, usually $550 to $600. Once the full amount is raised, the group or individual will receive a sampling kit to collect about 5 gallons of seawater to ship to the Center for Marine and Environmental Radioactivity at Huai. Buesseler's lab can process 2 to 5 samples a week, he said. Currently, his lab has its eye on 5 sites from Washington State to Hawaii it would like to see fully funded. Buesseler and his team have been collecting samples of water off Fukushima since shortly after the earthquake and tsunami. Huai scientists plan to return to Japan in May to conduct more research with colleagues in the Japanese scientific community. Okay, well, okay. So, let's see. Let's take a look at Woods Hole Oceanographic Institution here, which I am calling Huai. It's a private nonprofit research and higher education facility dedicated to the study of all aspects of marine science and engineering and to the education of marine researchers. OK, Okay, it is the largest independent oceanographic research institution in the U.S., and staffs and students numbering 1,000. It's organized into 6 departments, 4 ocean institutes, ocean life, coastal ocean, ocean and climate change, deep ocean exploration. Okay, its shore-based facilities are located in the village of Woods Hole, Massachusetts, and 1.5 miles away on the Quissett campus. The bulk of the institution's funding comes from grants and contracts from the National Science Foundation and other government agencies, augmented by foundations and private donations. Okay, WHOI scientists, engineers, and students collaborate to develop theories, test ideas, build seagoing instruments, and collect data in diverse marine environments. Working in all of the world's oceans, their research agenda includes geological activity deep within the earth, plant, animal, microbial populations and their interactions in the ocean, coastal erosion, ocean circulation, ocean pollution, and global climate change. Okay. Let's see, a little history. $2.5 million grant from the Rockefeller Foundation supported the summer work of 12 scientists, construction of a laboratory building and commissioning of a research vessel, 142-foot catch, Atlantis, whose profile still forms the institution's logo. Oh, that's a beautiful boat. WHOI grew substantially to support significant defense-related research during World War II and later became a steady growth in staff, research fleet, and scientific stature. Over the years, WHOI scientists have made seminal discoveries about the oceans that have contributed to improving U.S. commerce, health, national security, and quality of life. So, okay, I'm getting a little bit more confused because it wouldn't the issues with Fukushima fallout have to do with quality of life, national security, health, and U.S. commerce? Okay. These are their list of their research vessels, their boat fleet, their underwater vehicles. Most all of this equipment is on the East Coast. Okay, so I'm going to come back to this, but just a moment here. So let's take a look at the Woods Hole Oceanographic. Partners of the Woods Hole Oceanographic Institution are attracted here by the creative can-do environment we maintain in the lab and sea. This not only fosters breakthrough discovery, but it also supports further innovation and spurs entrepreneurial growth well beyond the institution. WHOI also provides our partners with connections in the worlds of research, engineering, and education that only a global leader in scientific research and ocean exploration can provide. Well, this sounds extremely all-encompassing, which doesn't make any sense to me why Ken Buesseler is trying to establish something on the West Coast of the United States to do water sample testing when that's what they do. So why pull in the public or organizations? Let's see who some of their featured partners and sponsors are. Okay. Government, United States, National Science Foundation, Department of Defense, National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration, National Aeronautics and Space Administration, U.S. Geological Survey, Department of Energy, National Institutes of Health, Environmental Protection Agency. Well, wouldn't it make sense that if these are some of their partners and sponsors, that this organization would be funding, dramatic funding, to find out what is going on in the oceans? And then the Government International, we have all of these all over the world. Then we have academic, we have all these universities. And one that comes to my mind straight off is the Scripps Institution of Oceanography, located in La Jolla, which is pretty close to down in San Diego. I have been here. This is an amazing institution. So, again, I beg the question, why would we send samples, gallons of water, all the way back to the East Coast to Massachusetts, when we have Scripps Institution of Oceanography right here? Okay, here's some other industries. I mean, just pick any one of them. Conservation International, Consortium for Ocean Leadership. These organizations are big organizations working in partnership with the Woods Hole Oceanographic Institute. Okay. So I'm going to go back in here. Let's look at the ocean institutes. Four institutes, one approach to interdisciplinary oceanography. These initiatives tackle many of society's greatest issues, including climate change, sustaining and conserving ocean ecosystems, and responding to disasters. The institutes provide seed funding for these high-risk, high-rewards projects. Responding to disasters, conserving ocean ecosystems, sustaining them. Coastal Ocean Institute, Deep Ocean Exploration Institute, Ocean and Climate Change Institute, Ocean Life Institute. There's four institutes right here. Now, I've gone through these. There is nothing in here about Fukushima. Not a zip. Look, they've even got this. News and highlights. Tracking toxic chemicals. Fate of an oil spill off the coast of California. They can do research on that, but they can't research the worst disaster on the planet of Earth. I'm not buying it. I don't believe it. I think it's all just one big hooey, just like it's spelled, W-H-O-I, hooey. As always, God bless.